I'm out of tune. You want to try this Monroe medley little deal?
Yeah.
One of the tunes that I recorded with Bill was Virginia Darlin'. And that was written about one of his girlfriends named Virginia. And, all right. Sound like the Grand Ole Opry's on right there. And anyway.
That's Monroe talking.
Yeah, that's Monroe. A ghost of Monroe. And then he wrote a tune that was very similar after I left the band called Road to Columbus. And then he's got another tune, a song rather, I'm on my way back to the old home. So we're going to do all those together just to prove to you that bluegrass does all sound alike. You won't be able to know. Just come in on the four, I'll have to leave my own home. somebody else's turn. We take turns, you know, it's only fair.
It's Keith's turn.
Keith's turn.
All right. Let's do Blue Mountain.
Okay. I knew it was that.
EB.
It's an amazing Sudafed. Thing.
It's great.
Sudafed for the head. Make you sing like that, but don't want to get me some.
I'll take what he's taking, yeah, I right. guess. How about we do all just pretend?
Yes.
Yep. That's good. I'll just pretend.
Something like that. You have to go with the tempo.
To ground to
Tune, Farewell Blues.
Yeah.
Been around for.
How do you do that again? How'd you do that? What'd you do? Doctor's
order. I give lessons on Tuesdays and Thursdays, 11 o'clock. Yeah. I went like this. Big orchestra like us, we have to tune a lot, so just bear with us.
I bet you I can get a hold of one once somebody's tuning a banjo.
Don't make me tell a banjo joke.
Just one.
Well, have you ever heard any? No, you haven't heard any, I'm sure. They don't get as far up here in New York, do they? Don't get that banjo jokes, do they?
Oh, yeah, we do.
Try them. I think there's a
banjo. No, I'm not going to. He'd get mad.
Banjo joke, wouldn't
it? Absolutely. We're in a cultural exchange here. Well, let's see. I'm trying to make one that's clean. Make one that's clean.
Especially here.
Difference between a banjo and a trampoline. You know that, don't you? People take their shoes off when they jump on a trampoline.
Never mind. It's very serious.
Trampoline or something to jump on.
Three, last time you said it, right?
Is this a banjo tune? Go ahead and play it, help me. Thank you.
Write this one, I think, back in the 70s, and he recorded it with the Dixie Pals, and I'm a big fan of those Dixie Pal recordings, and this is just a great tune called Dreams.
Tears, tears.
Mr. Eagle. What? How many bird watchers do we have in the audience? Anybody watch birds? Good. There's nothing wrong with it. It's a manly enough thing to do. It's nothing wrong. My wife and I watch birds every morning. We go out and walk in this park, and we watch all kinds of birds. Do you guys watch birds? They're not paying attention.
Band meeting.
We're figuring out how mockingbird. We're going to do a tune called Listen to the Mockingbird, and in this, you might be able to hear some of your favorite bird calls in this I do on the fiddle. I don't know if I can do them or not, but we'll see how my hand's working. Do you guys watch birds? You watch any kind of birds at all? Do you have any favorite birds you like to watch?
The doo-doo bird. No.
There probably is a hummingbird. You like hummingbirds. Mm-hmm. They are. Musical. I like that. And you like anything?
I've been watching some baby pigeons at the subway station in the morning. They're gestating, and I know, I think I got to get out of New York a little more.
That's the only pigeon there, I mean, bird there is in New York City.
Oh, no, actually, there's hawks. There's hawks in New York.
Oh, I'm just kidding.
But I do see quite a few pigeons.
Very good.
I guess that's what I'm watching most of the time.
Teeth, how about you?
Chicken, that's what I had for dinner.
All right, I like the chicken too. Actually, my favorite bird is the American bald eagle.
Very cool.
The bald part, that's what I like. You know, there's a medical research taken on baldness. I don't know whether you know this or not. For instance, if you have a bald spot in the back of your head, they found that you're a lover. And if you have a high forehead, they found that you're a thinker. True medical fact. If you're bald all the way across, you just think you're a lover. See that? So, mockingbird, he goes right to the egg. Jailbird. Here's my impression of a jailbird. Sawed his way out of that jail. Flew the coop. One of my favorites I like to do, if I'm feeling just right, I like to do a duck. Duck. Best I can do on that one. I can do a swallow. Oh, never mind. Let's get a little more foul and do Keith's favorite bird, the chicken. Just go to G chord. Play G for me. Perfect. Shaken in the key of G. You guys are such a good audience. You're starved for entertainment, aren't you? Let's do a, what else do chickens do? They lay eggs, don't they? Let's do a chicken laying an egg. You may wonder what that is. That is mood music to get the chicken in the mood to lay an egg. She's in the mood now, she's ready. Chicken laying an egg. This is chicken laying a great big square egg, if you could imagine that.
Ow. Oh my goodness. What now? There.
Changes everything.
You're
kidding. Yeah. You want to do it?
Oh yeah. And
me,
I never played
B
in my life.
That sounds like it's it.
It's hard to do there.
Sorry.
Rearrange and make it a sweet.
players don't sing that high.
He does a pretty good job.
I live on top of a mountain, you know. It's all those ears on the dairy farm.
Thin air. Yodel a lot. Yodel, hey!
No.
You can't yodel?
I can't. Maybe tonight. That's Sudafed, you know.
Anything on that list that we haven't done?
Should I do That Star Belongs to Me?
Yeah, she should sing some more, don't you think? Yeah. Is this show too slick, you think, maybe?
This looks professional.
That's how it is.
We're working on our Vegas act, so I hope that's not too slick.
All right, here we go. We got it worked out.
Okay. Famous song that Bill Monroe wrote about his uncle, which was Uncle
Penn.
Oh, they're good, aren't they? Disciples of Bluegrass. Yes. Yeah, Uncle Penn. I got to tell you a story. Bill and I were good friends. We really were. And he'd always rib me about something, and I'd kid him about something. And one time, I cut a record one time, and it was called Outrageous. I don't know whether you have that or not. It's a white album, just Myron Berlin on this outrageous thing. And I used all these studio musicians in Los Angeles. And J.D. Manus is a really good steel player. Played with Buck Owens and played with a lot of different people. And so I had not only bluegrass, but I had electric guitars, piano, steel, everything on, mixed in with it. Just something different, you know, and mostly original tunes. So I recorded that, and Bill Monroe came out to Los Angeles, and he was performing out there, and Kenny Baker was in the band. So I played this tape for Kenny Baker. I knew Kenny Baker would like it, you know. So sure enough, he did. Oh, that's really good right there. And he liked it, you know. Play that for Bill. And I said, no, Bill won't like it. I tell you that right now. Oh, yeah, he will. He'll like it. So we pulled up the motel, and Bill stand up on this balcony, and then Kenny said, come here, Bill. So he came down there, and I was in the car. I had this cassette playing, and I started the first song, and the first break in it was a steel break. J.D. Manus playing steel, and Bill Monroe goes, what is that right there? I said, that's a steel player there, Bill. Well, that just ruined it right there. And I said, well, that's your opinion. He knew he wasn't getting to me, you know. He goes, well, Barn, your daddy wouldn't like you doing that kind of music. And I said, now, what are you talking about? What kind of music are you talking about, Bill? And he said, well, that swing. I said, well, let me tell you something. My dad was listening to Bob Wills before he ever heard of you. So don't tell me he wouldn't like it, you know. And so he kind of went on. So just a few, maybe a year later, Ricky Skaggs recorded Uncle Pen. You remember that? Mm-hmm. And what was in it? A steel break, if you remember. Yeah. So I got Bill. He came back to L.A. again, and I called him out there. And one time I said, Bill, I said, what do you think of Ricky Skaggs' Uncle Pen? Oh, it was wonderful. Well, it got up to number one. That's why he said it was wonderful. Made him a lot of money, you know. Oh, it was wonderful. Well, did you hear that steel break in it, Bill? He goes, yeah, I did. I said, I don't think your Uncle Pen would like that at all. He looked at me and just laughed. So anyway, what goes around comes around, right?
A song before in my life. This is quite a special event.
You did really well.
Only to go up from there. It's called being tossed into the deep end of the pool. But with friends, so it's good.
Well, you didn't sink.
No, I didn't. Paddle right along. Just like Bill Monroe would want me to.
That's right. Well, we've run out of tunes. What do you want us to do now?
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Jerusalem Ridge.
Miller's
oh.
Real.
Oh, right. I had this my workshop today. All play Happy Birthday, their version of it. In fact, I had them do it in the National Fiddle Contest for their final round, final song. See what they could do from the jam on Happy Birthday. It was interesting, to say the least.
Nice hand for Jerry Olin on the banjo. Shane Lawson on the banjo.
She's the man back here. Give me a
Mr. Mike, right here on the mandolin. Mike the mandolin. Thanks for coming out and being with us tonight. We really appreciate you guys. In the Hudson Valley Bluegrass Association, thank you very much for putting all this together. And Fred, I want to thank you again for asking me to come up here and get together with Lynn and everybody to put this together. So, and another round of applause for this fine band right here. Aren't they great? I'm sure they had better things to do tonight on a Saturday night than come up and play with me, but I really appreciate that. Well, anyway, thanks again, you guys. It's been great. And so, I don't know, what would you like to hear our last song? Orange Blossom Special.
Big Mun.
Big Mun. How about Rawhide?
Oh, there you go.
No, he doesn't want to do that either. No, I don't care. I'll tell you what let's do. Let's do a little Faded Love and then we'll go into Orange Blossom. Everyone's watching.
Okay.
Faded Love. We did Maiden's Prayer earlier, so let's do Faded Love now. This is the Oklahoma fiddle song, state fiddle song, Faded Love. Bob Wills lived out there for a long time. It was on KVOO radio in Tulsa, Oklahoma for 20-some years. And, of course, he's around in Texas and Nassau, moved out to California for a while, too. But, you know, he was very popular in Oklahoma. down the railroad track. Oh, look yonder coming. Coming down that railroad track. It's the Orange Blossom Special. Bringing my baby back. Here we go. Thank you. Would you like to hear one more? Thank you very much. Let's do another instrumental, and this is called the Oklahoma Stomp.
Yeah.
This is I went to school at the University of Oklahoma, and this is what they usually do to their opponents when they play in the football. But not all, last year they didn't do so good, but this year they will.
The Oklahoma Stomp.
Spade Cooley, I think, did it. Well, Bart Blues, you know. Done on rhythm.